第23队表演题目是 Love in Other Countries， 计时开始。
Morning, students. Today we have a special guest, Adam, who has just completed his voluntary medical job in Senegal, Africa. Welcome our outstanding alumnus, Adam.
Hello, my juniors.
Why did you choose Senegal to do your voluntary work?
Well, it doesn't matter which country you make your contribution at all. Instead, what you have to care about is which place needs you most.
But I am afraid I'm not good enough to communicate with them in English. Can I go help others in foreign countries?
Language is not a barrier. It is your heart that connects the chain of love. Don't be afraid of that.
Wow, your experience really attracts me a lot.But as for my mom and dad, I don't think they will understand.
Didn't you have trouble communicating with your parents at that time? In fact, I had a serious fight with my parents. I still remember what happened on that day. Erica, are you kidding? I totally don't agree with your crazy idea. Say something else, father.Do not keep silent!
Well, Adam, do what you're supposed to do, please. Don't let me down. Stay in Taiwan and be a doctor's plan.
Mom, you've advised me to lend my hand to anyone you need. Dad, you've encouraged me to experience something different since I was a child. See, I'm on the way that you have always shown me.
Indeed, what you say is true.
Mom,Helping others is a blessing that nothing can compete against. That's why you've talked to me. I just want to be like you.
But you give up your dream of being a doctor. Is it worth it? Besides, Senegal sounds like a place in the outer space.
Mom, Senegal is far, really. Don't worry, I will set my medical study aside. I'll be an assistant of Dr. Miller. All I beg is your support and encouragement.Remember to wipe your mom with clean water every day. Keep your family from dirty water. Cholera is spread through polluted water.
I will do what doctors ask me to do. But clean water?
We understand the problem of clean water. Don't worry, you just take care of mom, okay? Adam, you know that the rain season is coming. And that means the number of cholera will increase in the following weeks.Lack of clean water. Most children have to walk far to get water for a whole family. Is there any solution to the problem? Sometimes I'm at a complete loss.
Sir, I've heard that Bill Gates is promoting a kind of machine called Omniprocessor, collecting human waste, turning it into safe and reusable byproducts, water and electricity.Perhaps we can give it a try.
How can we get started?
I go serve a website asking them what we should prepare for.
You really do a big favor to people here.
I go get it started right away. I can't wait to see those children's smiles.
Adam, your passion and contribution help them a lot.
Dr. Miller, actually, you show me how to cherish what I have, even a drop of water. This is the true meaning of exchanging.I come here to make a change to them at first. In the end, I change myself.
Wow! It sounds like you have more chances to enjoy the beautiful view in Africa.
Don't be silly, girl. Adam didn't go there for fun.
Of course, I was surrounded with differences. I even had little time to take a break.Not to mention enjoying a pretty sunrise or sunset.
Oh, it's too sad.
You'll be different once you put yourself in other shoes. Our school is planning to offer you an opportunity to experience complete new lives and to contribute what you've learned in school.
Really? What's that?
This summer, we'll provide students with an exchange program. By stepping outside Taiwan, we're able to prove to others that we Taiwanese senior students are capable of something unbelievable.
I always take what I have for granted.
I used to take myself too seriously.
It's not too late. Why not join us this summer?
We Taiwanese shouldn't isolate ourselves in the limited island.
I gave those in need medical care and a feed by me what I've never imagined. It's a mutual kindness regardless of
race, gender, religion, and wealth.
Adam, it's time to go home to talk with parents about the plan.
Guys, wish me luck. See you in summer.
Thank you.
第24对表演题目是 Right, Love is Right. 计时开始。
I can't believe we are in India now. It's our first time we come here as volunteers. I'm so excited.
Me too. Let's take a look around here.
Oh, I want to take some pictures. Wait a minute. There's a ceremony.
Yeah, but why the girl looks after that?
I have no idea. Let me enter.
What's going on, little girl?
Why are you so sad?
Your father. Excuse me, sir. Don't you know how old she is?
Of course I do. She's 12 and I'm guaranteed to marry her.
But how old are you?
I'm 55 years old. Ew. Is there any problem?
It doesn't make any sense. Don't you think she's too young for you?
No worries. I got her parents' permission. Besides, it's none of your business. Move out my way.
Wait, come back, come back.
Oh no, I have tried to stop it.
Oh, I've got an idea. Let me upload this video on Facebook to let everyone to notice it.
Hello everyone, this is Mark Zuckerberg. Have you guys noticed the video on internet? Oh my goodness, a child marriage happened again. What a terrible thing it is. I hope you can pay more attention on it and have more and more people help those young girls.
Such a big problem in India. We have to figure out a plan and keep the young girls away from this suffering.
Yes, and look, a lot of people give us so many feedback. And oh my god, there's an organization willing to help those poor girls. And they will arrive here in 2 days. We gotta help.
Here is child marriage, but that's unfair to those young girls. We think they cannot deprive of children's rights.
I can't agree with you more, but where's Kama's house?
Oh, I can take you there.
Okay, let's go.
Traditional to your religion.
Uh-huh.
Have you ever thought about it? Your girl is
going to marry a man she doesn't love, and she may be gonna domestic violence, even sexual violence by her husband.
I don't see any problem with this.
No, sir, it's a problem. Look, you take away her dream and give her a nightmare. If you love your daughter, please think about it twice. Your daughter has the right to receive education, to choose a life.
Okay, what do you think, Kama?
Sorry, Papa. I really don't want to marry an old man at all. I don't want to be his wife. I'm just a kid. I'm really scared.
There are lots of people support you in everywhere. See? People are watching and standing by you. Deep breath.
You are right. What for I am. I should respect my daughter and give her rights back. I'm sorry, dear. Let's cancel the wedding.
Thank you, Papa. I love you.
Congratulations, girl.
Thank you.
I'm so happy for you.
Thank you.
You did right decision, sir.
Nowadays, the child marriage is still happening in many countries.
And a lot of young girls cannot get rid of this slavery.
However, if we can give them more support, more love,
they will have more right to live, to be themselves. So, right,
love is right.
Thank you for watching.
第25对表演题目是 One Night Alley Youth Hostel， 计时开始。
How far we can get to the hostel?
I think it probably 1,000 meters away.
I'm too tired to walk.
Come on, you can do it. Hurry up, let's move.
There's a bus stop. Maybe we can take a bus.
Okay, let's go.
I think that you all will like it.
What? Why you can't eat beef?
Oh, I know. Each culture has different taboos.
You're right. The religion believers will follow their rules.
Loud sounds when we eat ramen.
Oh, for example, in Taiwan, if you hold a wedding, we give the couple the red envelope, but in Japan, they will give the white envelope.
Wow, you learn and know a lot!
Haha, thank you!
So, we have to respect all different customs. Hey, how about let's take a selfie to memorize this special memory. One, two, three.
Yeah! Thank you!
The 26 对表演题目是 Ambassadors Abroad, 计时开始。
97, 98, 99, 100!
Hey, Iris! Just a few more days and winter vacation begins!
Yeah, but I'm gonna
start training for my next triathlon! Are you also up for the challenge, Kyle?
Yeah, right, Brian. For me, it's all about R&R! Candy, here I come! Iris, why do you look so down all of a sudden?
My parents want me to be an exchange student in Ecuador!
That sounds exciting! What's wrong with that?
I really want to go!
Remember when I came back from Ireland last year and I told you how incredible it was?
It's just that, I'd rather stay here in Taiwan.
Hey, I think you should reconsider as this will be a rewarding experience.
Yeah, and by living with a host family, you'll be immersed in another culture and language.
Okay, maybe you're right. I'll go on this trip to Ecuador. I mean, who knows what will happen.
All right, your go. I want souvenir.
My parents are calling, I'm gonna go. But I'll contact you when I'm in Ecuador.
Sounds good, have a good time.
Contact us when you get a chance.
Okay.
Hey, I really want to go to Ecuador, you know?
Really? Maybe you should go with her.
Bailando, bailando. Dinner's ready, Iris.
Coming. I'm so glad to have you as a little sister.
Thanks. My parents will be back in a few minutes. Iris, tell me more about the delicacies of Taiwanese cuisine.
Tell you what, Charmy. Tomorrow, I'll make an oyster omelet.
Just a couple of scratches, but other than that, I'm fine. Hey, my dad messaged me, saying that my mom's hurt.
What?
She got hurt by some falling glass, but she's gonna be okay.
I'm sorry to hear that, but that's your life, right?
Hey, from the looks of it, many people didn't survive this quake.Houses have collapsed, and there might be people trapped underneath all that rubble.
You're right.
We shouldn't stay here and do nothing. Let's go.
Yeah, maybe there's someone waiting to be rescued.
When was the last time we talked to her?
I don't know. Is the car going through?
Can they see us?
Hey, do you think Iris is safe in Ecuador?
Yeah, I hope so.
Wait, wait, wait. Hey, we have a video chat with your friends. Let's go.
Hello, Brian, Kyle. This is my host, sister, Charmy.
Hello, Charmy.
Hi.
Thank God you're okay. The earthquake over there in Ecuador was all over the news here in Taiwan.
Charmy's mom got hurt in the earthquake.
Don't worry. She's almost fully recovered.
This one was pretty intense, but we survived.
It measured 7.8 on the Richter scale, and at least 661 people died.
Wow, I would imagine a lot of disaster relief organizations were quick to arrive, right?
Actually, in the aftermath, it was a challenge distributing water and food to the survivors.
I read that the president of Ecuador said that it was due to the lack of infrastructure.
We are in Taiwan, and we want to help.
how about we start an organization called Disaster Response International?
Hey, that's a great idea. We can offer a more timely response.
Yes, with us establishing disaster relief distribution centers in different parts of Ecuador.
Drones can be sent out first to assess the damage.
Then vehicles can be deployed and deliver supplies to those in need.
A lot of people still need water and supplies now. Hey guys, I need to find a water supply for the building. See you later, bye.
Bye. We could set up supply depots in Gwenga and Guido.
I'll manage supplies from Taipei.
Wait, what about me?
Kyle, you should be in Guido to distribute supplies and help out Iris and Charmy.
That's perfect, boys. Let's get started.
There's a lot of work to do. We should get going. Later.
Later.
Bye.
I'll manage Taipei and you'll manage Guido.
Works for me.
Hello, I am Charmy. It's an honor to be here today, speaking to all of you high school students. Now, let's bring the others out on stage.
Hello, I'm Brian.
I'm Ars.
And I'm Kyle.
All four of us share the same vision 10 years ago to make a difference in the lives of others.
You know, 2016 was a very tough year for Ecuador and Taiwan. Many people didn't survive from the severe earthquake and suffered a lot in the aftermath.
It was because of my experience in Ecuador, my whole sister Charmy, and my best friends that this organization was born.
With the birth of this organization, we were able to cooperate with other nations and establish partnerships.
That is correct, Charmy. Become an ambassador through doing relief work.
Or by becoming an exchange student.
Where you can experience life in other cultures.
Gain new understanding of the world and be a representative of Taiwan.
You can become global citizens today and make a contribution to our emerging world community. Thank you.
第二十七对表演题目是 Look at a leap that looks as red as a rose. 计时开始。
I want to catch a Pokemon, but I will be a Pokemon master.
Right. What are you doing?
I can't find any Pokemon. What are you looking for?
Right. I know there is a mission around here. I want to take a look.
Of course.
Great. Follow me.
Okay.
Here, touch panel.
What?
Hey, this is mystery entrance.
Huh?
Surprise. Hello, sir. Please follow me. Let me introduce your surrounding.I'm the ranger to produce this end.
First, English.
Wait, where am I? Okay, good question. Here is international exhibition.
Wow.
Sounds great?
Sounds great.
Yes, this exhibition is divided into 1, 2, and 3.
I'm counting until you're introduced.
Okay, what's the problem, preacher? On the first floor in the floor exhibition, where there are all kinds of beautiful flowers. On the second floor,Tony's neck, where Andrew can enjoy short food. On the second floor in the decoration intention, where Andrew can eat delicious food.
Sounds great.
Now let me take you to first floor.
First.
Let's go. This is first
floor. Hello, sir.Welcome to this flower hall on the first floor.
And you can go and visit. I have something to do, so I will go first.
Bye. Can you show me around first?
Okay, so let me introduce you to this flower. It's called a ghost flower. It's called a name of the people also known as Indian flower. It's simple, six away and appear to be a homestead. It's called.
Well, I want to know something Taiwan's flower.
Okay. This is a Renaissance from Taiwan. Renaissance is also known as Ocean. This is a simple. Very lucky.
That's also. I want to know something Taiwan's country.
Then you can go to the second floor and visit the second floor in the
Hello, welcome to Chinese Culture Center.
What are you doing?
Yes, I'm trying Chinese letter. By the way, let me introduce Chinese culture.
And this one?
This is Chinese jewelry. These are pieces of the Song Dynasty in China.
Why is that?
Oh, this is take out your paper umbrella. This symbol of number friendship.
I'm hungry. Is there smell some food?
Oh, okay, yes. The third floor just shows traditional food. I want to see?
Of course.
Great, follow me.
Taiwanese snacks exhibition. What can I see anyone eating? Because food is forbidden in the exhibition hall. Although their food is only being introduced, you can eat here. According to your inconvenience, also please forgive me. This smell sounds stinky, but I don't hate it. Why is that? This is a stinking dove. It was. Which one is? The rest is frog snacks. And this one? This is a pure milk tea. It was made in Taiwan.
Pure tea? But it is made in Western?
Yes, but pure gets added to milk tea was first in Taiwan. It can also be Taiwanese snacks.
So it is. Thank you for your explanation. I want to test eat some Taiwan food.
You're welcome. It is my show too.
Bye.
3, 2, 1. Thank you.
第二十八对表演题目是 Oh my God, 计时开始。
What are you doing? Don't you know I'm preparing for a difficult test?
Hey, shut up!
What?Let me see.
Hey!
Oh my god! What's this?
Haha, it's a game to grasp gods in Taiwan. Let me show you.
Lady, go!
Welcome to the game, Oh my god. Two gamers have to work on the level.
Who are you?
Hi, I'm your aside partner, Kelly from Taiwan. Let's pass the level together.
Taiwanese, how lucky! Where am I?
Oh, now we are in Dajia, Taichung, Taiwan. Here, we stand in front of Zhenlan Temple. Today is Mazu's birthday.
Who?
Mazu! See, tens of thousands of people come here to worship her by incense, fruit, and cookies.
Oh, wait a second. I still don't get it.
Oh, there's a hint.
Mazu was first considered the goddess of the sea to protect fishermen and sailors. As time went by, Mazu became a popular goddess in Taiwan to bless people in their daily lives.
Oh, I got it. Mazu is just like Poseidon, the god of the sea in the Greek mythology. But in Greek, we won't offer incense or kafu blocks.
Well, that's the most interesting part in Taiwanese culture.
Oh, we're running out of time. Let's start the game. Where's Mazu?
Where's she?
There she is.
I'm Mazu. In order to pass this level, you must answer my questions. First, what's my duty?
Oh, I know. To protect the people on the sea. Am I right?
Correct. Second, tell me the names of my patron saints standing beside me.
I don't know.
Hang on, I know the answer. One is Thousand Mile Eye, the other is Wind the Company Ear.
Are we right?
Correct.
Yes.
Then help me to know people's hardship. Yes, we did it!
I'm so happy to have you as my partner, Kelly. Thanks for everything.
It's my pleasure to guide you to know Taiwanese culture. Hope you like it. Bye!
amazing Taiwanese god culture is. Thanks to this magical app, I have known more about Taiwan. I would like to get further information about it.
Good afternoon. Welcome to Gloria Na Show. I'm today's hostess. Recently, the hottest game, oh my god, has been so popular among teenagers. Just within 1 week, the download number has increased to 20 million around the world. It has never happened before. The game designer from Taiwan is now here. Guess what? She's only 18 years old. Let's welcome Ivy Chen. Ivy, the game, oh my god, is quite special. How do you come up with the idea?
Oh, that's because I love traditional temple culture when I was little. I often visit temples as a worshipper and even search a great amount of information about it on the internet. The further I understand, the more I appreciate Taiwanese culture. As a result, I want to share with others how amazing Taiwan is.
Oh, so that's the reason you made this game?
Yeah, I just found that many teenagers love using cell phones. Therefore, by creating this app, I hope more foreign friends can understand Taiwanese culture.
From this video, we know this app is so successful and popular. So, what is your future plan?
Well, I would like to enrich this app by adding more foreign cultures so that the youth around the world can broaden their horizon through this magical app.
Oh my god!
With an open mind,
through the magical app,
transport Beitang Generation!
Thank you.
The 29th 队表演题目是 No Border Love, 计时开始。
Hey, wait a minute, I have something to tell you.
About what?
I saw a news about the shortness of daddy's price and medical in Kenya.
And then, can you help them?
I think I can donate some old clothes and shoes to them.
Oh, I remember Ariane Petty had experiences of international volunteering. Why don't you ask them? Ariane Petty, are you guys free now?
Yeah, what's up?
Can you give us a hand?
Sure, go ahead.
I know you and Patty had experiences of international volunteering.
Yes, we have been to Cambodia and Ethiopia before. We taught local children math, science, and English in local schools and provided basic health information to locals.
Besides, we also help people rebuild their houses. By the way, we are going to Kenya next month.
Great. In that case, we can collect some supplies and then you bring it to Kenya.
Sure, we can do that. I'm going to donate some old clothes, books, shoes, and toys. Oops, we are late for science class. We gotta go. Talk to you later. Bye.
Supplies this time. Those people in need must be very happy.
So sorry. Let's watch TV.
Great.
Look, is she Irene?
Oh yes, I can't believe it. She's on TV. It's a report about volunteering in Kenya.
Is this your first time to be an international volunteer?
No, actually, I have been doing voluntary work for 2 years.
Wow, that's impressive! Do you have anything you want to share with us?
Yeah, quite a few. Through volunteer work, I make many friends from all around the world, and I learn different cultures from them. Besides, there are still many people in the world who need help. It is urgent that we find a way to solve these problems.
Great! Do you have anything else you want to share?
Yes. This is the photo that I took yesterday.
Look, that girl in the picture. She is wearing my junior high school uniform, and I can see my name on the shirt.
Wow, that's awesome!
I feel very touched and happy because the little things that we do can make a huge difference to our world. It's so meaningful, and I will keep doing this.
Nairobi. It has a decent tourist infrastructure and lots of resorts along its coastline. The interesting thing is that there are only two seasons in Kenya. One is rainy season, the other one is dry season.
How about the economic situation in Kenya?
That's a good question. There is a great disparity between the rich and the poor, with very few in the middle class.
That's why so many people in Kenya need help from other countries.
Look, here's the photo taken 2 years ago. The girl standing by me was a volunteer from Taiwan. We've got lots of help from Taiwan these years. Thanks for your help. I can continue my study.
Hey, that's me. I am the volunteer in your photo.
Really? Let me see the photo.
I want to see too.
No wonder you look so familiar to me. What a small world.
Gosh, I can't believe it. I want to say thank you for your kindness and goodwill.
I just want to share my love to those who need help. We are so glad to have you in our class. We will show you how beautiful Taiwan is.
Okay, let's go.
Thank you.
The 30-day 表演题目是 PE Shoes Make a Difference. 计时开始。
My father, who is a scientist, has stayed in Africa in his early 20s. Seeing people in Africa suffer from the shortage of electricity, he made up his mind to do something for them. After having made efforts for years, he finally succeeded. Now,Tom and I are planning to bring his invention to Kenya. Let's go!
They took a plane to Africa. It's night time when they arrived in Kenya.
Tom!
Tom! What's going on here?
It's so dark.
I can barely see the road.
I almost forget that Kenya has been facing severe power shortages.
Yeah, that's why we're here. The energy production and distribution here, it's so scarce that it can hardly provide enough energy for people in Kenya.
Ouch! It hurts! Mom, where are you?
Shamaka, are you okay?
Sorry, I didn't mean it.
Oh, thank God, he's fine.
What's this?
It's giving a light.
It can be taken off from the bottom of the shoes.
Oh, this little gadget is amazing. And that's why we're here.
A pair of shoes?
Yes, but they're not merely shoes. They're one of my father's greatest inventions, PE shoes.
PE shoes?
Yes, PE shoes. P for power.
And E for electricity. You can try them on if you want.
Really?
Sure.
How do you feel?
Well, it's pretty light and comfortable. Is there anything inside?
Yes, there are batteries.
Let us walk you home.
When you arrive home, you will see how amazing the shoes are.
Our village is over there. Let's go there and have some tea. Thanks for your help. And you are?
I'm Hako.
I'm Tom.
We are from Taiwan.
Hi, I'm Jamaka.
Hi, Jamaka. Now you can take off the shoes. Now I'm going to pull out the batteries. You see, the battery is fully charged.
Wow, that's amazing.
The shoes are designed to generate and store the energy.
Tell me more about it.
Sure. You can take a look. The magic shoes are equipped with a device which helps transform the kinetic energy from your motion into the battery power. That is to say, when you walk on the ground, the friction between the two surfaces converts kinetic energy into heat. The device inside the shoes can absorb the heat and further convert it into the battery power.
The more you move, the more power you get. So when you put on the shoes and walked home, the energy was produced.
What can we use the energy for?
Can we use it to light up a house?
Definitely. All we need is a power cord to connect them.
Amazing! Mom, I can study all night.
Well, can we use it to charge our cell phones as well?
Of course.
It hasn't been used for a long time.
Mom, can we call Dad now? I miss him so much.
Please.
Let's try it.
What will happen?
You see?
Mom, it's charging.
Wow, come on, call your dad.
Dad, this is Jamaka. When will we come home? Great, okay, see you. Mom, please buy this pair of shoes for me. With them, I can not only study all night, but code at any time.
But we don't have enough money.
Don't worry, it's for you.
Thank you.
Thank you, how lucky we are.
We've signed a contract with a shoes company. The shoes have gone into mass production in Taiwan.
Everyone in the village can get a pair of PE shoes. It's my father's aspiration to help people in need.
PE shoes from Taiwan, make your life a better one. Taiwan number one.
第三十一对表演题目是 A Homecoming Voyage， 计时开始。
I'm a fashion design major. My teacher recommended me to join fashion design competition this year. But I always feel something is missing in my design, and that bothers me a lot.
Do 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 do.
Ashley, finally you picked up my phone call. There's an exhibition in the gallery. Can you go with me?
Yes.
See you then. Ashley, look at this Taiya photo from Taiwan. Their traditional clothes are amazing. Look how bright and vivid the color is.
Oh, come on, Tony. I have no interest in this kind of old school exhibition.
Hey, can you feel it? Is it an earthquake?
Oh no, Tony, look! The picture
archers to shoot one of the suns down.
But they failed. So there are still two suns in the sky.
And the prophet told us we should enlist a couple from the outside world to save our tribe.
It's going to be you guys. Come with us, please.
Okay.
What? You gotta be kidding me.
Come on. Oh. Maybe we can find a way out.
No.
Senshi Lusu Dageha. Gwai Miyaki Zu Suming Kong. Goi Migo Majo Lae, Lai Gao Jia. Jailang Hogwa Gamga Jo Jinsele. Now, I don't know if you understood what I just said, but it's my attempt to, well, it's, let me start by saying I like to tell stories. And in my comments, you'll hear a number of different stories. And this is the first one. When I first came to Taiwan many years ago, I was working at a university in Jiayi. I was working at a university, a small university, next to a very big university. And when I was there, I realized quite quickly that there weren't many people at the university who could understand my first language, English. So I realized I needed to learn something. I needed to learn the language here. And in southern Taiwan, that was my attempt to speak Taiwanese. So I feel like you are all competing in a competition and you're speaking in English. I thought I should at least try to say something in Taiwanese. As I said, I like to tell stories, and that was the first story. I want to talk about some of the positive things in terms of language that I heard, and I also want to talk about things that I think you can improve upon. The first positive I think that I'd like to mention is the enthusiasm that all of the groups showed in their performances today. To me, this is a bit of, there's some positive things to say about the enthusiasm. There's also some things that I think that could be improved upon, but that's not what I want to talk about with enthusiasm. I want to focus on the positives and the energy that you all put into your performances was commendable. It was something that you should be proud of. So that's the first positive that I want to mention. The second positive that I'd like to talk about is what I see as a growing knowledge of current events and perhaps a broader vision of the world from the performances today. I heard some groups talking about Kenya and Senegal, where in the past I've been to judge performances, and students would say things like, in Africa, thinking that Africa was a country rather than a continent. Today I heard some of you getting more specific about countries in Africa. I also heard a presentation or drama performance about Ecuador. And you're talking about things that are rather far away from Taiwan, but it shows that there's some knowledge about what's going on in different parts of the world. And I think that is also a very positive thing to mention to the group. The mention of things like Kenya, I think, is interesting on a couple of different levels. I'm a PhD student in New Zealand while I'm teaching here in Taiwan. And one of my office mates is actually from Kenya. And he likes to tell stories too. Perhaps now I can tell him one of the stories that I heard at least two drama performances today about his home country. I also think, and I don't want to be political on any level today, but I also noticed some things concerning one performance in particular, about international competitions. And I think we all know some things about how Taiwan is represented in international competitions. And I think today's event allows students to talk about topics that maybe sometimes we feel uncomfortable talking about in the general public. So I saw, for example, in one of those competitions, a student wearing a Taiwan shirt. Okay, I don't want to get too political about this, but it's just something that I thought was a positive. And the third point that I would like to mention is with the closing remarks or the closing statements from groups today. I've been to many performances. Many times I've been asked to judge competitions. And a number of times I've been to this school to judge competitions like today. And it's probably this closing comment that I'm going to make is probably something that you have heard before. In the past, I heard many groups saying things like, "Thank you for your listening," or "Thank you for your watching." And as a native English speaker, alarms go off in my head when I hear that. It's not quite right. I understand what students are saying, but it's not quite right. Today, there were some of those, but nowhere near as many as there were in the past. So I heard a lot of groups saying things like, "Just thank you," or even better, "Thank you for your attention." I think those are both okay ways to finish a performance. Okay, so that's a positive. Those are the positives. I do want to also talk about some things that you could improve upon. There are a number of things that I think you could do better in the future if you are asked to do another performance. The first has to do with the content of the performances, your skits, your stories. And the stories or the performances that I particularly liked were those that offered some kind of solution to a problem. It's okay, I think, to talk about the problems that are going on in the world. And a lot of groups did those sorts of things. But I think it's even better to come up with some solutions. It's the younger people of the world, it's the younger generation that is going to be asked to solve the problems of the world in the future. You guys who are performing today may solve some of these problems. So rather than just focusing on the problem, I encourage you to come up with some solutions. And some groups did that. Also in terms of content, a lot of the groups were talking about cultural differences between Taiwan and other countries of the world. And that's great. I think it's important that you know there are some differences going on in the world. But I also think that it's important that we focus on other things in Taiwan other than food. And this might be my own cultural misunderstanding. I know food is an important part of Taiwan culture, but there are other things here that I think we could also talk about, okay? And some groups did that as well. Some groups, they did it in a more hidden or subtle kind of way. I remember seeing, for example, a lot of computer names. I saw Asus and Acer and BenQ and these kinds of things in the performance. And those are also ways to show what Taiwan culture is like. These are products that are produced here. So this is something that I think we could improve upon. We can do more of this than focusing solely on food to represent Taiwan's culture. And I don't want to sound like that is the only thing that you guys who did the performances today did. You only focused on food. You did it. There were some that were talking about certain places. I remember one group talking about Alisan, for example. And so it's I don't want to sound overly critical, but it's just something that I hear over and over and over and over again. We're always talking about food, okay? The second point that I would like to mention in terms of improvement has to do with intonation. And I was discussing with some of the other judges during the breaks about this topic. And I was a bit unsure whether the issue of intonation, meaning this rising and falling of how we speak in English, was due to the nature or the nature of the performances today. Today you were asked to do a drama performance. And I think perhaps this idea of needing to do a drama or a performance maybe impacts or affects the way that you speak in terms of intonation. What I heard as a native English speaker is a constant rise in the intonation at the end of your sentences, and that's not always how it works. Again, these are general comments because I think some students today don't struggle with this. Okay, but I think overall it's something that could be improved upon. The third point has to do with language in general. And these are even things that I hear my own students who are college and university students at a language-focused university. I'm a teacher at Wenzhou, okay, which is generally a language-focused university. And so my ear hears certain things. I hear, for example, one group saying, although such and such and such, and then they continue the next part of the sentence by saying, but. In Chinese, I know you can do that, but in English, we can't. So if you use although and but, you can't use them in the same sentence, although this, but. Okay? Perhaps, I think you can do that in Chinese, okay? But not in English. And so this is one small point, language point, that I pay attention to. Another language-related point deals with pronunciation. And English is kind of a funny language, I think, in terms of pronunciation. But I'm going to give you some suggestions on how you can make improvements on this next one that's related to pronunciation. Some of you talked about clothing that was made in Taiwan. I remember one group talking about this shirt was made, or this jersey was made from recycled bottles in Taiwan. I'm not sure if this was the group who said this, but there was one group that said closes. Because that TH sound when you hear clothes is really not pronounced very clearly. A solution to this pronunciation problem when you're thinking about ifu is to think about close the door. So it's actually pronounced the same way as close the door. So if you say my clothes and you think close the door, you'll be pronouncing it correctly instead of closes. Okay? I hope you understand that. Sometimes I'm not sure I understand what I'm saying too. Another pronunciation issue that I heard, and it's common, I've heard it many times over the years, has to do with something called the schwa. Okay, and the schwa is this old sound at the end of words. So you hear words like people, and comfortable, and animal, and simple, and little. All of these have that same sound at the end. And it seems to be Taiwanese students have a little issue with this particular pronunciation feature. Because I hear things like simpo, lido, comfortable, okay? My hope is that I can raise awareness to these sorts of problems, issues. Okay? It's not meant to be mean. I'm not a mean person at all. I want to help improve your English. Okay? And one last issue I think that deals with the overall performances has to do with the volume on stage. Some students, it seems like they were almost yelling at us, speaking too loudly. Other students may be a bit high show, and they weren't speaking loud enough. So when you're on stage, you have to learn how to project your voice so the people in the back of the room can also hear what you're saying. Okay? All right. Now, I think all of these problems can be solved with exposure, more input. And how do we get more input? We can read things online. We can read things in books. We can also listen to how things are pronounced. Okay, so my encouragement for you to improve on these problems that I've identified is to listen more, to listen to native speakers pronounce certain words, native English speakers pronounce certain words. And the internet is one way that you can have access to this. Okay? Another story that deals with exposure and also I think is related to today's events. And it's a personal one because it relates to someone in my family. My sister is married to a foreigner, and they also live on a small island, but not in this part of the world, in a different part of the world. My sister's husband is also a diplomat. Yes, some of you maybe hope in the future to be a diplomat. That's today's competition about teen diplomacy, I guess, right? They have four kids, four girls. And on their island, he also comes from a multicultural family. His father was Portuguese, Putaoyaran, right? His mother was Spanish. On this island, they speak Dutch in the school systems. And they have a local language called Papiamento that they speak there. And my sister Kate speaks English to them. And all four kids, when they were very young, when they first started going to school, could speak five languages. And this is all, I think, due to exposure. I want to end with one little story and something that happened today during the break. Zhang Laoshi, who's going to be coming up after me to talk about some things, was very kind, and he gave us all a present during the lunchtime, the last break. And it was a very nice mug, and I appreciate that because I need a new mug to drink out of. But one of the things that I noticed in the wrapping paper that was wrapped around the box was the following. It said, language is opportunity. Language is opportunity. Think about that. You guys were all using English to communicate. And you're practicing using English to communicate the things that you are thinking about. And the places of the world tend to use English as the language of communication. Hopefully, we can use English now, or maybe in the future. Maybe someday in the future, that language will change to Chinese. I don't know. But we can use language to help solve some of these problems. Look at language as an opportunity. 谢谢。
各位女士，各位先生，非常感谢你们都来听我这个讲评。 刚刚石老师已经把很多的重点都已经讲过了，所以我只要再补充一下，大概就可以交差了。那今天我要特别感谢很多人，这个教育部、外交部还有公事啊，他们主办的这个 活动越来越好。那我个人来这边参加过几次的评审工作啊，那我有发现到不管是工作同仁还是老师的还有同学们的表现呢都是越来越好的。那所以我觉得我的工作呢一来很轻松啊，因为我只要坐在那边挑挑毛病啊，就是看一看就好了啊。但是呢有的时候我又觉得还蛮困难的，因为各位呢都有很好的很大的进步哈，使得我实在是我觉得除了鼓励之外哈没有什么太多应该说的，但是主办单位硬要我多说一些哈，所以我就想接在石老师的后面狗尾续貂一下。那么挑挑毛病，钻钻牛角尖，那如果这个我个人的一点点观察如果不是很适合你用的话，那你就忽略吧啊。那如果你愿意听一听的呢，我也十分的愿意跟你继续讨论。讲到此就是说各位都愿意来听这个最后的，可能不是为了我的讲评，可能是为了等一下宣布那个前十六名是谁啊。不过呢我觉得这个是应该是很有意义的，所以如果你被淘汰了，我也真心的邀请你明天你也回来这个听一听我们剩下两位这个评审要跟各位做的讲评好吗？那我是屏东大学的英语系的还有语言中心的张李红。那我非常希望跟各位有一些交流啊，所以如果你等一下你随时你愿意举手啊，我们来谈一谈，我们来聊一聊啊。那如果你离开了以后，今天结束了哈，我们今天没有机会谈，那也欢迎你到这个屏东大学来坐一坐，我们继续可以聊一聊。你来的话，我也送你一个 mug 哈。那请你不要走错，不要到屏科大啊，屏科大不是屏东大学，屏科大太远了啊。屏东大学呢就在屏东市啊。好，我接着刚刚那个石老师讲的，就是说，今年已经明显的减少了。我想可能就是因为，以前有留下来听讲解的缘故哈。今年已经明显的减少这个 "Thanks for your listening, thanks for your watching" 这种 language 哈。不但 your listening 不放在一起 ，your watching 不放在一起，即便你真的要讲 "Thanks for"。那你大概就是 listening 还是 watching， 可是你这个 listening 在什么时候用呢？很可能我举个例子，你失恋了，对不对？你失恋了，然后找你的妈吉，然后呢来跟他讲你多痛苦啊，你他多不该啊，然后你把这个苦水吐完了以后呢，你也许可以说一个 thanks for listening to me 啊，或者是 thanks for listening， 就是说你愿意听我吐苦水啊，那我很感谢，大概是这个意思哈。那另外我杂七杂八的再补充一下，就是你会发现现在已经没有了就是前面的那四个麦克风哈，那么基本上它已经准备好了，大概你往前面站一点哈，那个麦克风就比较容易收到你的声音，那你如果站得太后面呢就不容易收到你的声音，那后面的同学啊就不太容易听得到，不太听得到的时候呢你又可能希望他听到，所以你可能就会用呼喊的，你用吼叫的，吼叫的时候，这时候其实哈，一定程度的就影响到你的演出啊。所以我想跟各位同学谈一下，我没有在加分的地方哈，有以下几个动作是我没有加分的。第一个就是过度的笑容，我没有特别给你加分啊。第二个，过度的这个。高低起伏的不自然的腔调，我没有特别给你加分。还有就是刻板的内容哈，我没有给你加分。还有就是你的手势，有的时候比较特别的手势，我没有给你加分。比如说这个是几啊？比如说这个是几啊？可能我们都要思考一下，这可能跟我们的文化有关系哈，所以可能并不是所有人都一看就懂哈。那我知道各位同学呢表现得都非常好，那么在家里一定有很长时间的练习才有今天这么好的表现，我觉得应该给大家一再的鼓励哈，都不为过。因为有的时候哈，这个你刚刚听石老师讲，有的时候这个 外国人他也搞不清楚我们学英文花了多大的力气，对不对？这些人在家里都背了好久好久哈，那这个很辛苦，也很好。我给你一个小小的建议，就是说，你也许你要准备一个5分钟的表演，那么你在家的时候可能要准备一个更长时间一点的表演，因为你到了场，你到了这个现场呢，你可能会忘词，你可能会忘了一些该做的动作，那这时候呢，你就可以比较能够从容的应付哈。刚刚有我们的审判长呢叫我特别跟大家报告的，就是说常常在我们表演的中间有那个2 years later 3 months later 这种情形哈，所以不一定要拿一张纸写一个 2 years later 来告诉大家，可能呢用一种更艺术一点的方式啊，比如说背景音乐啦或者是你甚至于你的一个举手投足一个小小的动作呢，都可以让人家觉得是2年以后5年以后哈。好，有几个地方这个洋人可能不知道怎么告诉你啊，但是我希望我们能够来多讨论一下。那么我们在鞠躬的时候啊，也许也不一定要手拉着手，然后一起做这个动作嘛，哈。那只要这个很自然的跟大家说一个谢谢啊，或者再见啊，这样子，我认为个人认为就可以了哈。所以不用太拘谨，也不用喊一二三呐这一类的事情哈。另外有一个我讲过，这个发音是刚刚我接着石老师讲哈，就是说比较吹毛求疵一点，有一个音我发现。几乎这个出错的比例比较高一些些一点点。那 again 我还是非常的吹毛求疵的哈，就是 A 这个音啊，其实国语里面有这个音啊。来，你跟我念一下吧，妹妹背着洋娃娃，有没有？你唱过这个歌吧？对不对？那个就是妹啊，所以不要念作 may 啊，不要念作 said， 因为我刚刚有听到，比如说 don't said that。因为 said 是过去式了嘛，对不对哈？所以你只能说 don't say that 哈，所以这个 may 也是一样，不要念作 may 了哈。还有像什么 this is the world we live， 好像还缺一个什么东西，对不对哈？缺一个东西。还有 5 years， 那个 v 还是在的，好，不是 5 years 啊，不是这样子。那还有 finally 啊，不要念作 finally 啊。那我是建议啊，其实你慢慢的说，你都说得很标准的哈。然后我也听到很多像这个 frustrated 啊这样的一个说法，我会建议你就直接讲，来，我们来练习一下 frustrated 啊，举着放第一个中音就好了嘛哈。另外一个什么？我发现哈，因为我常常到小学去那个巡回这个观察哈，那我从小学里面我就发现有这样的一个问题，一直到大学生好像都还存在的这个问题，就是假设你会一个单字，你要把它拉高的时候，要把它变成问句的时候，表怀疑的时候，其实跟原本那个字你念的重音还是有关系哦。比如说，你本来是念 Ethiopia， 是不是？所以你给它拉高的时候，还是要照那个重音的地方拉高。好，我们试试看是不是 Ethiopia 啊？然后这个 Africa 对不对？所以你拉高的时候还是第一重音哦 ，Africa 对不对？那 possible 啊 ，countries 你应该或许可以考虑一下，因为我刚刚听了很多是它念作这样子。Ethiopia， Africa， 这个 possible， 还有 countries， 你知道我的意思吗？就是说你变成疑问句的时候，你那个重音应该还是在的啊，应该还是在的。还有比如说真的注意一下，有时候你太紧张了，我听到了 I'm come from 这样的一个说法，可能只是太紧张了哈。 然后有一个非常一致的问题，就是我们应该不用太紧张，好，你也不用太你背得太快太流利，其实你只要慢慢的讲清楚就好了，我们听得懂就好了。大部分的同学的这个发音啊什么都很好啊，那这个但是我希望你把每个字每个音呢、啊、都尽量念出来。比如说有一个字叫做 world 啊 ，world 啊，不是 word 啊，不是 word 和 world 还是不一样的哈。刚刚讲的那个字尾加了一些音，刚刚石老师有点到字尾加了一些音，那个比如说你讲 change 了哦。或者 peak 了哦啊，这个字尾这个 schwa 哈，这个叫做 epithetical e 哈，这个 epithetical e， 那这个你只要注意一下，把它拿掉就好了哈。其实你今天表现真的都很棒啊，这个我的学生都没有你们那么厉害啊，我年轻的时候也没有你们这么厉害，我实在是觉得你们很棒啊。如果其实我讲的还很多，但是好像时间的关系啊，我也不能再讲了。你如果愿意跟我沟通的话，我非常愿意跟你继续联络啊，就请你到打个电话到那个屏东大学的英语系啊。如果你愿意 email 给我呢，也很好啊，那个我们继续讨论一下啊。我的 email 呢就是。yingwenwenti 啊，你说这么长记不住啊，就是英文问题啊 @gmail.com 哈，英文问题 @gmail.com 啊，谢谢大家给我这个机会，我希望跟大家保持联系。好，我已经讲完了，谢谢。
外交部林科长，还有各位同学、各位师长，还有各位伙伴，大家好。各位同学很厉害哈，给自己一个掌声吧。你们都表现得很好，刚才评审老师有讲，那评审老师的刚才讲评，相信你们也收获很多，那也是可以学习成长很多哈。那能够站在这个舞台真的很不简单哈，会不会紧张吗？会。那我们来宣布晋级哈。那我们原来要入选16队啊，因为有同婚，所以我们就是晋级17队。入围的队伍有序号4，好，序号7，序号8。好，序号11，好，序号12，序号14，好，很好，序号16，好，18，好，19，20，22。23，26，28，30，31，恭喜这17队伍，希望你们明天有很好的成绩，能够入前6名，代表南区去参加决赛。
演讲题目是 Number 4，计时开始。
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. As we know, the number of people affected by humanitarian crisis has almost doubled in the past decade. The United Nations and its partners continues to respond to humanitarian needs and emergencies stemming from conflict or global challenges such as environmental degradation and climate change. According to an estimate of the UN,More than 76 million people from 31 countries needed humanitarian assistance, such as the homeless, refugees, as well as victims of natural disasters, wars, and famines. What's more, due to the mounting disasters in recent years, the number of people in need of help has been on the increase. Also, humanitarian assistance is growing as well. The primary purpose of humanitarian assistance is to save lives, alleviate suffering, and maintain human dignity. Humanitarian assistance is concerned with financial resources and emergency supplies governed by the principle of humanity, impartiality, neutrality, and independence.
Last year, I joined an event called Right for Rights, which is held by the Amnesty International. Every December, Amnesty supporters write millions of letters to people whose basic human rights are deprived. As far as I am concerned, I motivated my family, friends, and classmates to advocate for human rights around the world. We have done our utmost to live out the true meaning of promoting human rights for those who are in need. For example, Wong Feifei used to be a human rights defender and secretary general of one of Myanmar's largest students' union. However, she was arrested by the police in 2015 because of their peaceful demonstration against educational law. Fortunately, she was released in 2016. Above all, Wong Feifei is just one of five Right for Rights cases that benefits from people's endeavors for those in 2015.
Moreover, volunteer is one of the effective ways for us youth to make contributions to humanitarian assistance. For instance, International Student Volunteers, ISV for short, is a program which has had more than 35,000 students participate across six continents from 2002 to 2016. Their mission is to support sustainable development motives around the world and through the efforts of student volunteers. Youth volunteers will support sustainable development projects that can provide basic community facilities, educational, recreational, as well as social learning. Take their efforts in Thailand, for example. We all know that in some villages of Thailand, the conception of sanitation is still in its infancy. The poor sanitation system may put the villagers' life at a big risk. As a result, building restrooms in the local community makes a big difference to their lives. Even though we are senior high school students, we can still sign up for International Student Volunteers programs in winter break or summer vacation to devote ourselves to international humanitarian assistance.
Tragic wars and rebellions take place in many countries around the world every day. Not only man-made disasters, but also natural disasters result in humanitarian crises. In the aftermath of disastrous incidents, many people were in need of the shelters and assistance. To help them alleviate suffering and make their way through the grief, we can reach out to those people by writing life-saving letters and volunteering in the construction of basic community facilities. In addition, we can also contribute to humanitarian assistance by utilizing the power of internet and resources to help them alleviate the suffering. As technology advanced, we have wider ranges of approaches to putting our efforts into the international humanitarian assistance endeavor. With the aid of internet and video, we can readily inspire those people by writing life-saving letters. We can readily inspire those people. All in all, we youth are certain to make contribution to the international humanitarian assistance if we are willing to open our mind and reach out our hands to those people in humanitarian crisis. Thank you.
Bow.
Thank you for your attention.
Number 5. 计时开始。
Good morning, dear judges. With the increasing integration of economies around the world, the movement of people and knowledge across different borders, as well as intercultural communication, the so-called globalization has become an unstoppable force over the world. based on free market capitalism and powered by advances in telecommunications, transportation, and finance. Globalization enables companies and individuals to establish relationships anywhere in the world. Globalization increases people's freedom to shape their identities and sharpen their talents. Moreover, it allows consumers to buy the best the world has to offer, while giving producers the tools to find buyers and partners worldwide. However, globalization is forcing difficult changes similar to those introduced by the Industrial Revolution. Industrialization created anxiety and fear, and demanded that workers learn new skills, and so did globalization. That is, people around the world are forced to continually improve their job skills, add greater value, and increase their opportunities.
High school students like us are no exception. And the truth is that globalization can be slowed down or turned down, thus preparing ourselves for adjusting to the new globalization system can be the top priority. That is, it is crucial for us to adapt to the best of our ability and develop global perspectives. Despite the fact that we may not have as many opportunities as adults to actually get involved in a multicultural environment, we do have some chances to prepare ourselves for the cultivation of our global view. First, a good command of English is necessary, and a second foreign language will make one more desirable in the international society. To achieve proficiency in a foreign language, we should take advantage of school-provided resources and continue sharpening skills in college and even at work.
Second, extensive reading, including classic literature, provides us a profound insight into foreign cultures. Those feelings described by literary masters are not limited to time and space. If we imagine ourselves being with those characters depicted by James Joyce in Dubliners, we might have a rough understanding about what Dublin was like at that time, which helps us in some way to get more knowledge of Ireland. Third, I believe a regular reading news reports on news websites such as BBC helps form the habit of caring about the international affairs. Constantly paying attention to what people in other countries have been through makes us considerate to others and appreciate what we have in Taiwan. Therefore, I won't focus on domestic news, but I will be eager for global affairs. Plus, the internet offers us access to the latest international news, regardless of the time and the distance.
Last but not least, facing the challenge to the way people view the world and their place in it, lifelong learning plays an essential role in striking a balance between preserving our sense of identity, culture, and community, and thus made us ready to compete, but not to disappear. Going global seems to be a process in which people strive for more information and knowledge so that they become more capable of dealing with a competitive world. Preparing ourselves with a global mindset is necessary, whether it is for better communication or a sense of commitment. To equip ourselves with the ability to acquire and utilize knowledge, we study hard, read substantially, assess the latest information, and pursue lifelong learning. It may not cost us dear, but it gives us a valuable asset.
演讲题目是 Number One， 计时开始。
Good morning. In today's information age, the internet has changed our lives a lot. Almost any teenager have a cell phone, and they can use their cell phone to do a variety of things. They can use their cell phone to capture whatever they see, write down their story, and upload them onto YouTube or Facebook. Teenagers can use their cell phones and spread their thoughts and their ideas in a faster and a quicker way.
Take Sunflower Movement, for example. This movement was launched by college students in Taiwan. At the same time, much information about movement, such as news, video clips, was recorded and uploaded on the net. This event was even broadcast live by translating what happened in Legislative Yuan into English, so that people around the world can get further information about the movement. That's why some Hong Kong students do that for them. Just because these college students spread these messages through the internet, the world get informed and then support them.
Additionally, the earthquake striking Japan drew great attention among Taiwanese through international news reports on the internet. Some students launched various activities to encourage people to assist Japan, like establishing money raising platform or dispatching rescue teams. Even some celebrities wrote songs to encourage the victims to stand up again. Because of their generosity and assistance, Japanese show much kindness in return. This event is the best example of using the internet to spread information around the world.
Well, the internet is ubiquitous. We should select the internet such as Facebook and YouTube more wisely. By selecting the good websites, it will make a teenagers increase their knowledge and broaden their horizons. Without this platform, we can convey our needs and spread our thoughts through this platform and can draw everyone's attention immediately around the world. Moreover, the interaction with teenagers has been more and more effectively through the diplomatic relations among nations.
Thank you.
Number 4, 计时开始.
The crisis is incredibly severe, but it isn't new, proclaims OCHA, Office for the Coordination of Humanitarian Affairs. Armed conflicts, epidemics, famine, natural disasters. People are dying around the world every day from these crises and other complex emergencies. How should we, as youth, contribute to the provision of humanitarian aid? Honorable judges, ladies and gentlemen, today, we're going to present some ways for us to offer international humanitarian assistance. Now, let's hear from Charmy as she recounts her remarkable time in Africa as a volunteer.
Thank you, Brian. I would like to share with you about my experience this past summer as a volunteer. During my summer vacation, I volunteered in a special project for children in Tanzania. When we arrived, we found that Tanzanian children live in houses without floors. They didn't even have any desks in their schools. So we started to paint the walls and make cement floors and desks for them. I still remember the expressions on their faces when they knew that the days of standing up in class without desks to use were no more. One thing that struck me the most happened in a junior high school. In an English class, I gave a piece of candy to a little girl who had just answered a question. Seeing her tear up the wrapper, I thought that she was going to eat the candy. To my surprise, she only licked the wrapper and then wrapped it up again. She really hesitated to eat it. Not until that moment did I realize how well off I was. Honestly, I never thought that I would have had such an amazing trip. Iris, would you please share with us some information about volunteer sending organizations?
No problem, Charmy. I would like to introduce TIMA, Ciji International Medical Association. It's an international organization that has volunteers in 50 countries with 502 offices worldwide. Their main mission concerns the needy and the sick. They provide free medical care to those who are unable to afford the cost of treatment. Ciji has conducted many free medical treatments in mountainous regions and other remote areas. In the event of natural disasters or other emergencies, the organization's volunteers are quick to respond to the affected areas to treat the sick or wounded victims. A reporter asked one of the volunteers why he participates in these events. It's different from a normally experienced day to day, said the volunteer. Ciji's dedication to the needy, the field of medicine, and international relief work is inspirational to Taiwanese youth in that
we too can get involved and make a difference.
Kyle, can you tell us about how youth contribute to humanitarian assistance?
Of course, Iris. Founded by a Taiwanese youth, Chen Shengkai, in 2010. Empowering Lives Through Innovative Volunteerism, ELIVE, has gathered hundreds of youth volunteers in just 3 years. Their goal is to help the poor and create a better living environment. Every year, volunteers devote themselves to this humanitarian aid project and provide overseas services to the needy. Youth volunteers teach villagers in Cambodia and Myanmar organic farming techniques and how to reconstruct their farmlands and houses, with the ultimate goal of the villagers becoming self-sufficient. Thanks to this project, teenagers in Taiwan step out of their comfort zones and experience these serious circumstances firsthand. Volunteering through ELIVE not only increases the global perspectives of young people, but also provides Taiwanese youth with opportunities for international collaboration while exporting their expertise and motivation abroad.
From the aforementioned examples, we strongly believe that the youth of Taiwan are very willing to join national and international agencies to participate in supplying humanitarian aid to others. Even though we are just teenagers,
we are fully capable of making efforts in humanitarian assistance.
Passing on the knowledge that we've been given
through persistence
and having a positive attitude,
we hope that one day
more global citizens
will catch the vision
and be active participants
in responding to humanitarian crises. Thank you.
Good morning, dear judges. Our topic number is one. In the information age dominated by the internet, how should online resources, e.g., platforms such as Facebook and YouTube, be used to conduct youth diplomacy? Born in the information age, the internet is everywhere in our lives. Apart from updating with lots of junk information, the internet can be used a lot more wisely and meaningfully. Have you heard of youth diplomacy? Yes, it is a good way to build our global vision and contact with the world. And now, we can connect these two, the internet and youth diplomacy, together. Social media, such as Facebook and Twitter, allow us to make a friend around the world. Diverse lifestyles and intriguing cultures will amaze you. Borders aren't the limits to exchange anymore.
video is also an effective approach to interact with the world. Platform, like YouTube, provides free and friendly environment to users who are willing to upload or watch videos. Recently, Facebook has even come up with a new function, live webcast. Through those online resources, it is possible for us to perform under the spotlight of the world. The internet has not only changed the way people live, but subverted the thoughts people have. The revolution enables us to share our ideas, rather than simply input our partial perspectives. We used to laugh only with people around. Now, we can share our happiness with people all over the world. As the saying goes, joy shared with others is more enjoyed. However, we youngsters must do more. Worldwide affairs need our participation. On the net, international news is everywhere to be seen. Follow some websites or Facebook accounts of non-profit organizations, such as Greenpeace and Doctors Without Borders, and you'll be able to catch up with the world. We can comment on global issues, expressing our visions of the world. No matter who you are, go speak out on the internet to show your concern, whether you're shocked by terror attacks, whether or not you are interested in American presidential candidates, or whether you're indignant at celebrities' corruption. Just exchange your viewpoints with invisible netizens. Then your global vision can be built, and so can Taiwan's international visibility. Globalization is not only a slogan, instead, it is a work in process. Despite the fact that we all live on the same planets, we still have diverse lifestyles, languages, cultures, and religions. However, as one of the residents living in this global village, we should link up with people living in other parts of the world instead of being isolated in the limited space. Through a variety of social medias, such as the internet, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, we not merely enrich ourselves, but also broaden our global horizons. We Taiwanese are an important national asset and also a source of national power. We can show our vitality and creativity while concerning our neighbors in this global village. Though it is true that the globe is becoming hot, flat, and crowded, it is also true that the world is full of love and care. A broader vision means having a rich experience to embrace much more varieties, being qualified to be a real global citizen.
Thank you.
Number 2, 计时开始.
Good morning, everyone. In the era of globalization, if we want to maintain Taiwan's predominance in international competitiveness, it is essential that our youth possess not only contemporary knowledge, but also a global vision. Through volunteering abroad or cross-cultural exchanges, Taiwanese youth not only expand their life experiences, but also build up their international perspectives and leadership abilities. In response to this irresistible trend, our government provides various channels, like the iYouth platform, through the Ministry of Education. In addition, many private enterprises, as well as non-government organizations, such as Commonwealth Magazine and International Cultural Youth Exchange Taiwan, are also dedicated to bringing our youth to the world.
To begin with, the iYouth platform provides a great channel through which Taiwanese youth can participate in global affairs. For instance, the International Youth Ambassador Exchange Program encourages Taiwanese young people to apply their diverse skills and talents to cross-cultural communication and international relations. they travel to several nations, building diplomatic relations or having friendly exchanges. Their missions are to enhance global awareness of Taiwan's roles in many international issues. One example of this youth international participation is a 5-member Special Youth Ambassador Corps accompanied Taiwan's observers delegation to the World Health Assembly in 2015. These youth ambassadors, who are students from universities all across Taiwan, participated in the WHA to bring their knowledge and to learn more about global medical and sanitation issues such as public health, malaria, and surgical care.
For the private sector, Taiwanese youth can enhance international engagement through cultural and creative industries. The massive power of social media and the internet transcends the boundaries of countries. Take Baba Chen, for example, a Taiwanese girl who was one of the only 2 successful candidates selected from Taiwan in the Best Jobs in the World campaign by the Australian Tourism Board. She initiated the project titled Small Island, Big Song, to connect Taiwan with the Pacific Ocean and the Indian Ocean via music. Collaborating with musicians from many countries, she creates music and videos to demonstrate the linkage of Taiwan with the world. Furthermore, the project unites the islands on the Pacific Ocean with those in the Indian Ocean and raises the islanders' awareness of the issues they face in common, such as the rising sea levels, immigration of tribal populations, and the loss of local languages. Chen's project will unequivocally earn a top place for its tremendous effort and contribution to a genre of world music.
Furthermore, many private enterprises offer youth abundant opportunities to engage in the international community. One of these enterprises is Commonwealth Magazine. Its iDream project provides young students with not only various chances to be international volunteers in non-government organizations, but also scholarships to study overseas or be committed to research on medicine, sustainable energy, and other critical issues. Among them, International Cultural Youth Exchange Taiwan encourages the youth to explore the world through intercultural learning experiences. It recruits volunteers from abroad to get involved in education, community service, elderly and disabled care, and so on. For instance, you may choose to join a team of the IMNI School in Colombia. It's a non-formal educational program targeted at disadvantaged kids with the aim of providing learning guidance. Or if you're fond of nature, you could head to Costa Rica's Pacific Coast to protect the green turtle. These volunteers assist in many areas, including maintenance of the beaches, as well as conducting night patrols and ensuring that the turtle hatchlings reach the sea.
After hearing of so many avenues to engage in the international community, can't you just wait to pack your belongings and get involved in cultural exchanges with your counterparts abroad? Whether you opt to be a youth ambassador or guarded turtles, you're bound to have fulfilling experiences as you are making a difference in the world.
Thank you for your attention.
The演讲题目是 Number 5, 计时开始.
Globalization has been an important part in modern times. Even though we stay on a small island, we're already involved in this globalized world, where products, capitals, information, cultural values, human resources, and other forms of culture and commercial activities are transnationally shared and exchanged. The market and working opportunities, the possibilities and challenges for our youth no longer exist in our own country alone. Instead, we simultaneously cooperate and compete with people all around the world. It is crucial that we reconsider the essential abilities for Taiwanese youth to stay competitive amid the wave of globalization.
The first fundamental thing is to improve our communication skills. Because of globalization, it becomes more frequent for us to work with foreign colleagues or deal with transnational affairs. For instance, a sales assistant may need to communicate with an Indian computer engineer to release their product in the States. How can they work efficiently? Communication is undoubtedly a big challenge for people who need to cooperate or compete with people of different cultural backgrounds. However, the challenge can turn out to be an opportunity for us. For improve our communication skills, we may try to strengthen our English ability, take second foreign language courses, or learn effective communication strategies. By doing so, we may become more visible in the world competition.
Second, mobility and adaptability. Globalization makes the world change at a much faster speed. Furthermore, there's a growing trend for young people to work or study in foreign countries to pursue more possibilities. To adapt ourselves to the rapidly changing environment and foreign cultures faster, the youth in Taiwan should cultivate an eclectic and open-minded attitude toward various cultures. We need to appreciate them and acquire knowledge about international affairs and histories of our neighboring countries. Besides, we also need to equip ourselves with the ability to work abroad. We can start with organizing activities at school, participating in international conferences, exchanging programs, or transnational volunteering, all of which require and enhance our communication skills and adaptability. The more quickly we are able to adapt ourselves to the new wave, the more competitive we will become.
On top of communication skills and the adaptability of living in various kinds of environments, what also makes us more competitive is our professional competence and the ability to keep learning. Due to globalization, the spread of information becomes much faster and more frequent. Therefore, knowledge acquisition should not be restricted to our local and traditional curriculums. We should combine what we learn from the text with current global waves. With the help of our government and several institutions, we have sponsorship for overseas study and the opportunities of overseas internship, both of which allow us to obtain professional competence and become familiar with current trends in our field of interest. Besides, thanks to the advanced technology, we are granted plenty of online resources to keep learning outside school. We can take courses from a great number of universities in Taiwan or abroad on internet for free, such as Coursera, OpenCourseWare of National Taiwan University, or Harvard. By taking part in these overseas activities and online program, we are likely to stand out from other international competitors.
We were not only born in Taiwan, but also live in a world that is getting closer. Through the cultivation of the above abilities, we hope Taiwanese youth are able to broaden their horizons, develop essential skills for future challenges, and recognize themselves as a member of this globalized world, so that we can stay competitive and reach more challenging goals. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Today, we're going to talk about topic 4. Due to advancement in transportation and electronics, the concept of a global village is now greatly embraced by the world. Now, people from even the most geographically distant country are actually closely interrelated. It is no exaggeration to say that as citizens of a global village, each and every one of us should shoulder responsibilities for making the world a better place to live in. Believe it or not, prosperous as Taiwan is, There are many places in the world where food and water are scarce. Educational opportunities are limited. Survival is threatened by wars and natural disaster. It is in the places like this that international humanitarian assistance is most needed.
Thankfully, both government and non-government organizations in Taiwan have spared no effort in providing humanitarian aid worldwide. As for us youth in Taiwan, there are three ways that we can contribute to global humanitarian assistance endeavors. First of all, we can start by caring about issues like famine, water shortage, human trafficking, and man-made or natural disasters that are ravaging different corners of the world. To get a word out, we can visit websites that address these issues, click like or share on social media posts, or take part in discussions. Such simple acts can help raise public awareness, which in turn may elicit public sympathy and bring about a collective effort to alleviate victims' suffering. In addition, expressing concern will give the people who dedicate their time to giving humanitarian aid a morale boost and let them know that they are not alone in doing the right thing.
Secondly, we can support global humanitarian endeavors by donating. Giving a small list donation can help organizations carry out their humanitarian assistance goals. As the saying goes, a penny and a penny laid up will be many. Similarly, if every one of us make a small donation, the total amount will be incredible. In addition to money, we can also donate critical relief supplies, which will especially help in impoverished disaster areas. Last but not least, we can actually participate in international volunteer work. Organizations like the International Humanity Foundation are constantly recruiting volunteer workers to help people suffering from disasters.
Take an Indian Ocean earthquake that struck Indonesia in 2004, for example. The 9.0 magnitude earthquake triggered a deadly tsunami that killed hundreds of thousands of people and left hundreds more injured, homeless, or displaced. In the aftermath of the disaster, volunteers flew from the world to help locals rebuild their houses and infrastructure, provide free medical care, education, and provide emotional support. All in all, by showing our concern, making donations, and actively participating in international volunteering projects, we, as youth in Taiwan, can greatly contribute to global humanitarian aid endeavors.
Together, we can make a difference in the world.
Thank you.